Hi, my name is Maddy, and I'm an instructor with Wordfence. Today, we'll be talking about our premium feature, country blocking, and showing you how to block selected countries from accessing your site. Country blocking is a great way to limit access to your login form on sites where there are just a few people who need to log in, or where all users logging in are doing so from just a few countries. Country blocking can also be used in cases where you do not do business with some countries and want to limit which countries can access the site. The first thing to take into account when you use country blocking is whether you want to block certain countries from accessing your whole site, just the login page, or both. Let's head over to the Wordfence firewall blocking page. Here we see a block type section in the middle of the page. When we click country, we notice we now have the option to select what we want to block, either the login form, block access to the rest of the site, or both. For this example, let's select the login form. If your site just has a handful of users who log in, and the users log in from just a few countries, using country blocking is a great way to limit the brute force attacks you see. In our case, we only have a few administrators who log into the site, and they do so from the United States. So let's click the Pick from List link under the Countries to Block header, and we notice a new panel opens with a list of countries to choose from. If you're planning on selecting a large number of countries, which we recommend only doing so if you're blocking the login form only, you can use the Block All button in the top right. From there, we will deselect the countries we do not want to block. In our case, after clicking Block All, we will scroll down and deselect the United States. Be sure that the country you or your users will be logging in from is not selected here. Once we select the countries to block, we can click the Block the Selected Countries button in the bottom right corner. We now notice in the current block section that we have a country block. Now when users from blocked countries try to access the portion of the site we selected to block, they will receive a Wordfence block screen mentioning access from their area has been limited, and it'll look like this. Now that we know how to set up country blocking, let's take a look at a few country blocking options that Wordfence provides. From the Wordfence All Options Blocking Options area, we see a tab for Advanced Country Blocking Options. Here, there are a number of settings that can make country blocking more powerful. First, we can see the option, What to Do When We Block Someone. For this, you can opt to either show the standard Wordfence block message or, alternatively, redirect them to a site of your choice using the Redirect to the URL Below option. Below that, we have options for Bypass Redirect and Bypass Cookie. These unique options allow you to give site access to visitors that are either currently blocked or will potentially be traveling to blocked countries in the future. Let's first look at the Bypass Redirect option. This method can help in a case where a visitor or someone on your team is currently being blocked by country blocking and you want to give them access to your site. Here, you'll set up a hidden URL, such as /bypass URL, and when that page is accessed by someone who is currently blocked by country blocking, Wordfence will then set up a special cookie that lets them bypass country blocking. To set this up, simply fill in the two fields shown that define what the hidden URL is and where that user should be redirected to after Wordfence has set the bypass cookie on the visitor's device. For the option where to redirect that user to, you might want to make this your home page, which is what I did, or some other starting point for the user once they have their access set. Keep in mind that these URLs are relative URLs, which means that they only include the path, such as what we see here with /bypass URL, rather than the entire site URL and path. Below this, we have a bypass cookie setup option. This is a way to ensure that someone who currently has access to your website is not blocked in the future by country blocking. This is good if you or team members of yours are planning on traveling and you want to ensure no one will be blocked by country blocking. For this setting, if user who is allowed to access the site views the relative URL, you will again want to enter URL such as /bypass-future as we see in our demo here. Again, these do not need to be real pages on your site, but can instead be a made-up URL that you will simply visit when necessary. If any of your visitors hit that URL, then they will receive a special cookie that will allow them to bypass country blocking in the future. That's how to set up country blocking on your site. If you have any questions, please leave us a comment below. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to securing your WordPress website.